For all of you up late, here's one to take you back to 1986.
Harlan, you in there? You have to let me in. It's an emergency. I know you're in there. I can see the light on. Come on, let me in. I'm your brother, for God's sake. I missed a bad this time. I promised them I'd have the code. Now they're all coming after me. Hurry, they're here. Open up. What are you doing? Come on, open up.
I can't let you in, Charlie. Not this time. Sorry.
They're going to kill me this time, you understand that? Please. Please, no, wait. I'll give you the code. Just don't kill me. Oh, no, please.
Sit down. We need to talk. To all we've been through,
last night's how you repay me?
Can I get an ice water, please?
Sure.
I'll have a coffee, black.
They gave me one more shot. 7 p.m. tomorrow night. Don't you ignore me. You know why I'm here. This time I'm not alone.
This is not happening. This is not happening.
Stop. Krill is only here to ensure you cooperate.
Thank you.
Hey, where's my coffee?
You're not still doing that ice thing, are you?
Where do you think you're going? We're not done here. Codes, Harlan. Tomorrow night. Hello? Is anybody there? Hello?
Codes.
No. Please, don't. No. Please, don't. No!
Seems so real.
Well, these hallucinations look and feel real because the neurotransmitters in your brain are unbalanced. Are you currently taking any recreational drugs?
No.
The severity of your condition is at a point where I'd like to get you on a low dose of Levexia.
No. The last doctor had me on Risperdal and started showing signs of TD, so I stopped taking them.
Risperdal. That could account for the recent increase in violent hallucinations. Antipsychotics require a weaning off process. Levexia side effects are more mild. You shouldn't have an adverse reaction to it at all.
I thought you said you could treat me without any medication.
Well, in order for the cognitive therapy to work, we need to stabilize your brain chemistry. Otherwise, you might not be able to reorganize the patterns your brain is creating.
What patterns?
Well, each of the hallucinations, you know, that you perceive are a creation of the subconscious. As a result, each illusion has a subtle trait or a trend that only you can identify. So why don't we start with Charlie? Tell me more about Charlie.
Charlie died when I was 15.
He died?
A car accident.
Car accident. When you see him now, do you notice anything different in his appearance from how you remember him before? Something may be shared with your other manifestations, like a color, a sound, any kind of trend.
He looks just like he did last time I saw him.
Last time you saw him?
Lying in his coffin. Do you have any ice?
Excuse me?
Ice cubes, just ice.
Let me look. Here we go. Here's a couple of cubes.
Thank you. What's with the leg?
It's an old basketball injury. Just flares up once in a while. Tell me about this ice habit.
It calms me when things get too overwhelming. Something about the way it melts. It's consistent. Reliable. Something real when all else fails.
That's good. Your brain is developing mechanisms for finding its equilibrium. Now, what I'd like to do is to find some mechanisms that are self-reliant. That way you don't become a prisoner to outside influences. Now, I want to see you back here on Thursday. Until then, take the medication I prescribed. And the next time Charlie and Crow return, I want you to look closely for traits they might share. All right?
You think this is gonna work?
The therapy is only intended to teach you to discard your paranoid delusions.
Oh, sorry. Oh,
I'm so sorry.
Sorry, it's my fault. I was distracted.
No, it's fine.
Harlan? Oh my God! How are you?
Allison.
You look really good. What have you been doing to yourself?
What are you doing back here?
My father passed away last week. But... here, take down my number. Give me a call sometime. It'd be really good to catch up.
Yeah, no, I'd like that.
Okay. Don't forget to call, okay?
It will work when you make a conscious decision to not let your illness interfere with finding personal happiness.
Hello?
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 Hey. Hey, it's Harlan from...
Oh, hey. I'm so glad you called.
Yeah, no, I hope it's not too late.
No, not at all. I'm a night owl. Wanna grab a coffee?
Yeah, sure. I mean, you thinking of a place?
You have reached R&J Prosthetics. If this is an emergency, please hang up and dial 911. Otherwise, leave a message after the beep.
No, that place is, it's perfect. It's only a couple blocks from me. Great, see you in say, 30 minutes then? All right, see you there. Bye.